Hello everyone, it's Bea. Welcome to Unit 2, The Chemistry of Life. But wait, I thought this was a biology course. Why are we learning about chemistry? Well, it turns out that it's impossible to truly understand the living world without chemistry. What organisms are made of, what happens to the food we eat, how plants capture energy and grow, even DNA, which contains the instructions for life. It's all chemistry. We'll start our exploration of life at the smallest levels, even smaller than most microscopes can see. Then, as we move through subsequent units, we'll build on our chemistry foundation to examine life at larger and larger scales, eventually reaching the entire biosphere. Let's begin our tour of life by investigating the chemistry that allows life to exist. I bet you've seen this before. It's the periodic table of the elements, but what do all of these rectangles represent? And what do they have to do with living things? And what's the relationship between elements, atoms, molecules, and life? By the end of Unit 2, you'll have answers to these questions. I bet you've also seen nutrition labels on the food you eat. But what do all of these rows mean, like fats, carbohydrates, and proteins? What exactly are these substances, and what roles do they play in living things? Stay tuned to find out. As you move through the unit, don't forget to complete the PDF notes and activities which accompany each video. The PDF attached to this lesson contains all of the PDF pages for the whole unit. Don't worry, there's no PDF to complete for this video. Just download the document and print it out so you have it ready for the rest of the unit. You can also find copies of the PDFs for each lesson located after the lesson videos. Now, get ready to zoom in close, I mean really close, and explore what living things are made of. Until next time, remember, biology is more than just science. It's the way of life. Hey, hey.